नमस्कार स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ कीर्ति जोशी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फूड बायोटेक डिपार्टमेंट. एंड दिस सेशन इज अबाउट एनाटॉमी एंड फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ किडनी. द मेन फंक्शंस ऑफ किडनी. द मेन पर्पस ऑफ द किडनी इज टू सेपरेट यूरिया, मिनरल सॉल्ट्स, टॉक्सिन्स एंड अदर वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स फ्रॉम द ब्लड. They also do the job of converting water, salt, and electrolytes. At last, one kidney must function properly for life to be maintained. A kidney is of bean-shaped, reddish-brown organ, about the size of our fist. The measurement is about 10 to 12 centimeters long, covered by a tough capsule of fibrous connective tissue that is called renal capsule. Adhering to the surface of each kidney, two layers of fat to help cushion them. Concave size having a depression where a renal artery enters and the renal vein and a ureter exit the kidney. Located in the upper rear region of the abdominal cavity, just above the waistline, protected by the rib cage, the renal cortex, the renal medulla, and the renal pelvis are the major regions of the kidney. The left kidney lies slightly above than the right kidney. This is the diagram of our kidney. Now, kidney and their structures. The renal artery that transport oxygenated blood from the heart and aorta to kidneys for filtration. The renal veins transport the filtered deoxygenated blood from kidneys to the posterior vena cava and the heart. Renal capsules, inferior and superior, outer membrane which encloses and protects kidney against infection and tumor. The renal cortex, outer layer granulated of the kidney that contain most of the nephrons. Now, moving towards the nephron, it is the basic microscopic structures of the kidney. Inside each kidney, there are about 1 million nephrons. Physiology of the kidney used for filtration of blood and reabsorption and secretion of materials. Now, the ureters, it is right and left. This is the ureters. Tubes that transport urine from the renal pelvis to the bladder. The urinary bladder, hollow expandable muscular organ located in the pelvic girdle, functions as a temporary reservoir of for urine. Thank you. This session is powered by digital version 2.0 JVW University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. Namaskar students, myself Dr. Kirti Joshi, Assistant Professor, Food and Biotech Department. This session is about acute kidney failure. Acute kidney failure is sudden, often reversible in a patient who had limited function earlier. When kidneys are not able to carry out their normal functions of maintaining the internal chemical environment of the body by filtering out the waste and excreting them, it is known as renal failure. It often develops due to gradual obstruction of renal tissue by the disease, or may occur suddenly as in nephrosis or obstruction of the tract. When the glomerular filtration rate rapidly drops to less than 20 ml per minute, there is a fast rise in the serum urea and creatinine level. When the rate drops further to 10 ml per minute or less, an excess of urea and other nitrogenous weights appear in the blood, which symptoms of uremia. Now, symptoms: inability to urinate, with urine output decreasing to less than 100 ml per day. At this stage, the patients may suffer from drowsiness, weakness, fatigue, or may have headache, itching, or blurred vision. Acute renal failure leads to death in 1/4 of the cases. The percentage increases to half if the patient is over 75 years or there is associated trauma. Dialysis has proved to be a boon for such patients. It is instituted until kidney function is regained. Now, diet therapy. In the first 24 to 48 hours, food and liquid intake by mouth are restricted. Glucose is given intravenously as oral intake is limited due to nausea, vomiting, and lack of appetite. Sometimes tube feeding or total parenteral nutrition, that is TPN, is used. Dialysis is essential when TPN is used. A protein-free diet may be given before a patient is put on dialysis. Another approach is to give glucose with essential amino acid orally or by tube feeding. The fluid allowances is about 500 ml to make up of insensible water losses plus the urine output. More fluid is provided if there is vomiting, diarrhea, fever, etc. to prevent dehydration. Now, energy. Energy intake should be enough to prevent catabolism. 20 to 40 gram of protein is given with gradual increase to normal levels to improvement in renal function or kidney functions. The serum electrolytes and urine output are constantly monitored so that the appropriate diet and fluid intake adjustments can be made. Diet is modified as the patient regains normal kidney function. In the recovery patient phase of ailments, a high protein, high calorie diet is needed by patient who is suffering tissue damage. Dietary fat and cholesterol may be limited to control hyperlipidemia. The patient may not have good appetite and may need to encouragement for attending relatives and dietitians to consume the diet presented completely. Appetizing and acceptable preparations will help the patient to enjoy the diet plan. Thank you. This session powered by Digital Version 2.0 by JVW University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. Namaskar students, myself Dr. Kirti Joshi, Assistant Professor, Food and Biotech Department. This session is about chronic renal failure. Gradual loss of kidney function is beginning, but if it silently continues, the glomerular filtration rate begins to reduce, leading to chronic renal failure. Kidneys have a vast reserve capacity, which allows them to support life through much of this progressive deterioration. When the glomerular filtrate rate, that is GFR, drops from normal 125 ml per minute to less than 30 ml per minute, dietary modification is initiated when the GFR reduces to 3 ml per minute, dietary control is not sufficient and dialysis or kidney transplant is necessary to save the life of the patient. Now, moving towards diet therapy, firstly we discuss about energy. To prevent tissue breakdown and release of nitrogen and potassium into circulation, an intake of 1,900 to 2,000 calories per day is indicated. Main sources of energy are carbohydrates and fats. Their metabolic end products do not pose a problem for the kidney, as these are excreted through lungs like carbon dioxide and sweat glands, that is water, and bowel, that is semi-solid residues. Protein intake is reduced to reduce work of kidneys of excreting and products of protein metabolism, namely urea, creatinine, uric acid, sulfate, and some other organic acids in the urine. Most of protein, that is 65 to 75% in the diet, should be of high biologic value. Minerals like potassium and sodium intakes need to be restricted to avoid hyperkalemia, edema, and hypertension respectively. Phosphorus is often restricted to 600 to 1200 mg per day to prevent metabolic acidosis. Supplements of calcium, iron, and vitamin D needed to be given, as restricted diets are low in some essential nutrients. Calcitrol may also be given as supplement, as the kidney is not able to produce vitamin D hormone. Fluid is restricted when urine output is low. The total fluid intake is equal to volume of urine output plus about 500 ml of insensible losses. The fluid intake includes water present in foods and beverages also. Thus, 100 ml of milk provides 87 ml. 100 grams of fruits and vegetables provide 80 to 90 ml of water. Thank you. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0 JVW University. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. Thank you.